Hello all, welcome in this video session. Today my discussion is very important topic, that is the GRIR clearing account. Okay, basically a GRIR clearing account is a bookkeeping device that can be used when goods arrive before the invoice is generated or the when the invoice arrives before goods are delivered. Okay, so what is the case? In the effect of the NEGO, in the case of good receipt, in case of the material purchase order, and service entry sheet in case of the service purchase order. Okay, let's take an example and do the practical. Okay, suppose we have placed a purchase order of 3 quantity of any material, or the amount is 42969. Okay, so once we place the purchase order, then we book the expense in certain GM. Okay, and after the supply of the good receipt, we will do the good receipt, that is NEGO. Once we do the NEGO, the stock GL is debited with the same amount and the credited with the temporary account. Okay, and that temporary account is known as GRIR general ledger account. Okay, so what's happened? We will open the purchase order in some screen and do the discussion. Okay, we just want to open the purchase order using ME23M. Place the purchase order with respect to this vendor, and the quantity of this material is 3 kilometer. Okay, the 1 kilometer price is 14,323 kilometers, and the vendor has supplied this material with this date. Okay, on this date we have received this goods of amount of 3 kilometers. So we will go in the purchase order history and see this NEGO documents. Okay, click on this is the NEGO document. Okay, and see this 3 kilometer received in our store, and go in the document info. This is the NEGO document, and go in the document info, click on the FI document, that is the financial document. Once you click on this, a accounting document is generated. Okay, see this stock GL, that is store of cable, is debited with 42969. Okay, stock is debited with 42969, and that temporary account is GRIR clearing account is 1311201 is credited with the same amount. Okay, so once we do the good receipt, then that temporary account is credited with the same amount. Okay, why we are asking, we are explaining and terminating this is a temporary account, later we explain. Okay, and after the good receipt, the vendor has supplied the invoice, and then we, our accounts and finance team will do the invoice verification, that is MIRO. Okay, so in this purchase order, on the next day we have received the invoice and done the invoice verification using this document number. This is the MIRO document number. So if we open this document number, see, and this is the MIRO document number, and if we click on this follow on document number, there is an accounting document, and if we click on this accounting document, see what happened. Effect of this invoice verification is that temporary general ledger account is debited with the same amount, 42969, and vendor is credited with this amount plus some GST and TDS. Okay, plus GST plus TDS. Okay, fine. So basically this here after the receipt of the after the good receipt, this temporary account is credited with the same amount, and here this temporary account is debited with the same amount. Okay, the net effect of this GRI clearing account is zero. Fine, the same amount is credited after the good receipt, but the same amount is credited after good receipt and same amount is debited after the invoice receipt. Okay, so this temporary GRIR clearing account is nullified, and that's why this account is act as a temporary account, that is the bookkeeping device. Okay, and generally it's nil value in this year. Okay, so we will see in the SAP document. This is the MIRA document. After the invoice verification, see, the vendor is credited with the same amount plus TDS GST and something like this 42969 plus IGST. Okay, and GRIR clearing account 1311201 is debited. Okay, 0 clearing account is debited. Fine. So the net effect of this general GRIR clearing account is nil. Okay. So what is the GRIR balances? Practically, in case of ideal condition, the GRIR clearing account should be zero. Okay. But sometimes it's not possible to do zero amount in this GRIR clearing account or in this temporary account, because good receipt, sometimes good receipt but not invoiced, because invoiced now supplied by vendor rate, but sometimes good invoiced supplied but not received at goods. Okay, sometimes for example, we have ordered the purchase order for the 100 quantity, but vendor has supplied the 90 quantity of this goods, and for the 10 quantity, this purchase order is yet open for good receipt and invoice receipt. Okay, so there is some effective balance in this GRIR clearing account. Okay, sometime accounts department have done the mistakes while doing the invoice verification due to any reason, or some mistakes due to good receipt. In good receipt, so due to this, the GRIR balance is not nil. Okay, so this is all about good receipt, invoice receipt clearing account, GRIR clearing account, and this is act as a intermediate account between the MIGO and MIRO, that is good receipt and invoice receipt. Okay, hope you understand this topic and concept. Okay, this is purely a training purpose tutorial. Okay, if you like this video, press like button. It will give us motivation to create more conceptual video. Please share this knowledge with your colleagues and friends. Okay, if you are new in my YouTube channel, please subscribe my YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay, if you have any doubts and query or suggestion, please mention in the comment box, and also reach us at erpsapteam1@gmail.com. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Keep smiling. Bye bye. See you in the next video. Take care.